Breaking at 5, Senators Marco Rubio and Bill Nelson have introduced a new bill in Congress to help with our water crisis. The South Florida Clean Coastals Water Act would direct a task force to assess Lake Okeechobee and come up with an action plan to solve the algae issues.
Continuing our team coverage now, the toll algae is taking on your health. These are new pictures from the Greeley Canal in Cape Coral off Veterans Parkway near Everest Marina.
And neighbors are complaining of the sight, the smell, and how it's making them feel. NBC2's Delia D'Ambra is live from Southeast 21st Avenue. She talked to Poison Control about how many calls they're getting because of the algae.
Dozens of people have called Florida Poison Control Centers complaining of health issues because of exposure to this toxic blue-green algae. It is disgusting out here, and it smells awful, like pure sewage. We uncovered there's only one agency in the state tracking cases related to health problems, and everyone else isn't.
Never seen anything like this. You can almost walk across the water.
And some things are walking across water with blue-green algae, like this alligator crawling its way along the surface of a Cape Coral canal covered in blooms.
It looks like a swamp is what it looks like. I mean, a bad swamp.
The swamp on the water's surface can hurt your health. The Florida Department of Health warns against exposing yourself to the algae because of toxic cyanobacteria lurking inside.
The smell's awful. It smells like a sewer pit or raw sewage.
Today, the Florida Department of Health says despite knowing the algae is a health hazard, it is not responsible for tracking cases of people affected by it. The Florida Poison Control Centers is collecting that data. Since last November, 57 people have called Poison Control concerned about blue-green algae. More than half of those callers reported direct exposure and poor health. With only one agency monitoring problems, residents are upset health providers aren't doing more.
Keep records how many people are coming in and get numbers to see how people are affected, children, adults, etc.
Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission is tracking animal sickness and deaths associated with blue-green algae and cyanobacteria exposure. NBC2 uncovered necropsy results from ducks found dead in a Cape Coral canal, suffered from toxic poisons, and their organs were stained green.
We reached out to Lee Health to find out if the health system is tracking blue-green algae health cases, and we're waiting to hear back. If you're feeling any adverse effects from exposure to blue-green algae blooms, you're asked to call the Florida Poison Control Centers to report it. You can also find that number on our website, NBC2.com. I'm live in Cape Coral, Delia D'Ambra, NBC2.